You know, I haven't had any experience with mental health personally, but I've seen it around me, and I know it affects a lot of people. So I thought it's something that needs to be addressed, and I'll put my hand up to help out. People probably have this perception about players being these big sort of tough guys, but you know, behind closed doors, you know, we're all normal people, and we're struggling and dealing with things like everyone else is. So, you know, you see people that are down each day. You know, obviously some guys are struggling and stuff like that. So, just, you know, it's evident and things like that. So I just thought, you know, we need to address it and try and help people break this stigma about mental health and be able to speak about their feelings. So, yeah, I thought it was a good initiative from the NRL, and I'm happy to help out. You probably see it around that certain guys struggle to speak about things or are a bit quieter than other guys, but that doesn't necessarily mean they're battling with demons. But there is, you know, when people get injuries or, you know, when losing games or their form sort of, they get dropped to reserve grade or whatnot, you can tell people are struggling and things like that. So different people deal with it differently, but, you know, I guess we've just got to try and help each other out. Everyone has sort of days where they're not as upbeat as other people, but, you know, if you see someone constantly struggling day after day, you know, week after week, if they're really down, I guess that's a strong indicator that they're battling mental health. Just because you can't physically see someone hurting, you know, it's a real issue, it's a real illness, and we just got to make everyone realise that you know, you can speak up, you can seek help if you're struggling with things, and you know, make sure people aren't looking down on things like that. It's actually real, it happens. It doesn't matter what you know, social class you're from, or if you're wealthy, you're poor, or what background or culture you're from. You know, everyone can suffer mental illness at some stage in their life. I still remember my first few years, I was really quiet, shy, things like that. So, yeah, just trying to make people feel comfortable around the boys and things like that. So I guess that's what I'll be trying to do. Well, there's always help around, you know. We've got welfare officers at the club. You know, we've got senior player, we've got people, coaches, you know. Obviously, you're not going to, some people won't feel comfortable talking to a head coach, but, you know, hopefully some people feel comfortable talking to the boys or, you know, or the doctor at the club or things like that. So just making sure everyone knows that there's support there and that they're not alone. It's been pretty documented, you know. We've had some, you know, some pretty serious things happen in our game the past few years with some deaths and whatnot. And, you know, probably a lot of it's contributed to mental health. So just breaking the stigma and, you know, trying to help people feel a lot better about themselves and just making sure that, you know, as a game and as a people, that we're you know, we're supporting each other and making sure no one feels like they're alone. You know, don't bottle everything up all the time. Get a good network around you, people you can, you know, good friends, people you can trust, you can talk to, and just, you know, exercise, eat good foods. Just try and live a healthy life, because I think that'll help a lot of it too.